this, the Gresley A4 Pacific. For my money, the greatest steam locomotive ever built. As you can see, every surface of this enormous machine is smooth and curved, minimizing drag and maximizing speed. The driver, Stuart Nellums, and his fireman have been here since before dawn, heating the boiler and creating enough steam pressure for us to run.
Steam pressure is round about the 250 pounds per square inch mark. We need a minimum of 150, so we're well ready for the off.
The enormous steam belching engine feels like it's alive. And now I'm going to get to drive it. My greatest loco of all time.
You can take the brake off, moving towards the windbag.
When I'm looking at the brake,
there we go. That's it, lovely. And then onto the really important handle, which is the regulator. Now that lets the steam.
We're rolling a little bit anyway,
yeah,
but
she's on a little bit of a gradient. If you ease that open, there she goes. Pause like that a second. Okay, and you can just feel the takeoff.
Yeah.
There's an awful lot of power on the end of that handle.
A lot of power on the end of that handle.
That's right. Exactly.
And then you put it back to where it was.
Basically, we're letting 50 pounds of steam into the cylinders.
Right.
Out of a potential 250.
Okay.
Now we've got going a little bit, you can now alter the reverser a bit.
Okay.
To make better use of the steam.
Right.
So go back up to sort of 45, something like that.
Okay.
Off we go to Edinburgh.
But you can feel the power as soon as you open the regulator and get moving.
That's right, there's an awful amount of power there.
Power on the end of that handle is very evident. It really is. Okay.
We're just rolling now, so we just let a little bit of the momentum go.
So that's just the momentum
that's
we're rolling
momentum,
on now. Incredible.
Yeah.
Incredible.
Trains do just as much rolling as they ever do with power on.
Yeah.
And the more weight you add, the quicker they'll go.
Oh, yes. But no matter how fast and powerful a locomotive is, it doesn't make a train. So before we go any further, we've got to pick up 6 or 7 carriages in that siding over there. I've driven an A4. That's fantastic. That is fantastic. And the sense of power is greater than anything I've ever driven before.
Gresley's ultra-streamlined A4 began service on the 1st of October 1935. It was an instant success, smashing the journey time from London to Newcastle to just 4 hours. But that success was very nearly a failure.
Gresley's streamlining made the locomotive incredibly fast and efficient, but the prototype had one major drawback.
A drawback that meant you might get to Newcastle very fast, but you'd resemble a smoked kipper by the time you got there.
It wasn't just air that flowed beautifully and smoothly over the surface of the engine.
Smoke from the chimney did too, carried along the surface of the loco and onto the footplate and into the carriages. Definitely not good for comfortable travel, but solved by a piece of luck in the wind tunnel.
During testing, someone managed to leave a thumbprint on the model by mistake, right here behind the chimney. But as luck would have it, once they fired up the wind tunnel, they found that the thumbprint actually solved the smoke problem.
The indentation caused by the tester's thumb interfered with the streamlining just enough to let the smoke escape from the surface of the engine. So that thumb hole became part of the real locomotive being cast into the full-size chimney.
But the thumbprint wasn't the only clever part of the A4's chimney. It also has a device called a Kyle-Chap double blast pipe, which improves the drafting of the fire, which makes the A4 go even faster.